A warm welcome to the students of BCom first semester to the session on the subject Corporate Structure and Administration, Unit 1, Formation of Joint Stock Company. In this session, I'll be discussing on the topic Articles of Association. The contents for today's discussion are Introduction to the Background of Articles of Association, Meaning of Articles of Association, Definition, Contents, and the difference between Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. We shall also discuss the most likely questions which are expected in the university examination. Let's begin with the introductory aspect to Articles of Association. Every business needs to be governed and it has to be controlled. Therefore, every business unit or institution must have its own rules and regulations for an efficient management of its affairs. In case of public limited company, it is the Articles of Association that serves this purpose. The Articles of Association are the internal regulation of a company on the basis of which its internal matters are managed. They lay down the powers of the directors, shareholders, and officers. It is a document that defines the purpose of a company and specifies the regulations for its operations. This document outlines how the job or task should be accomplished within an organization, including the preparation and management of financial records and the process of directors' appointments. The Articles of Association can be considered as the user manual for the organization that comprises of the methodology that can be used to accomplish the company's everyday activities or day-to-day operations. This document is a binding on the shareholders and the organization and has got nothing to do with the outsiders. Let's understand the meaning of Articles of Association. In the earlier session, I had mentioned Memorandum of Association is the primary document, whereas Articles of Association is the secondary document. It contains the laws regarding the internal management of the company. Are the legal document that along with Memorandum of Association serves as the constitution of the company. It comprises rules and regulations that governs the company's internal management or managing of internal affairs. Hope you understood the meaning. Let's understand the definition. This definition is given according to Companies Act 2013, Section 2, Subsection 5. An article refers to the original article of association of a company or a version that has been altered so as to comply to the laws stipulated in the Act. Section 5 of the Companies Act 2013 defines the article of association as the document that contains the rules and regulations regarding the management of the company. Section 2, Subsection 5, the articles of a company shall contain the regulations for management of the company. They are framed with the object for carrying out the object stated in the Memorandum of Association. The articles should contain everything which matches with the Memorandum of Association. That is, the article should not contain anything which is inconsistent with either the provisions of the Memorandum of Association or the Companies Act. So, dear students, you have followed the definition of Companies Articles of Association, which is given according to the Companies Act 2013, Section 2, Subsection 5. Let's now understand the contents of Articles of Association. It gives complete details about the various types of shares or classes of shares, values of their shares, and the voting rights attached with each of them. That is, the equity shares, and the details related to preference shares are clearly mentioned. Next, contents about calls on shares, procedure for transfer of shares, forfeiture or conversion of shares, and alteration of capital. It contains the details relating to appointment of directors, the power of the directors, and the duties. It also gives details about the procedures of conducting meetings, that is annual general meeting and other meetings, including the details about minutes of the meeting, notices, and so on. The types of bookkeeping of accounts and auditing procedures are also mentioned. With regard to the appointment of internal auditors and external auditors and matters relating to remuneration paid to these auditors are also specified. To continue with other contents, it gives complete information about voting rights. In case of proxy, even such details are specified. Details relating to dividends, that is distribution of profits, reserves, are also stated. Next, in case of winding up, the procedure to be adopted is specified. The directors' details, such as the borrowing powers of the board of directors and managers, are also stated. Matters relating to subscription of shares, which is related to minimum subscription, is also specified. And in joint stock company features, we have understood the feature about common seal. So in this articles of association, all the rules relating to usage and custody of common seal is specified. Rules relating to regulations, conversion of fully paid shares into stock is mentioned, and details relating even to lien on shares are specified. And the contents can be drafted according to the requirements of the company, not necessarily to have all the 14 or more than that is not compulsory. So based on the company's requirement, they can draft the contents. Now, in earlier session, we understood about the primary document memorandum. In this session, we have understood about articles. So it is necessary for us to differentiate between both. So let's understand the differences between memorandum of association and articles of association. The first difference between both, that is memorandum of association, describes the powers and objects of the company, whereas articles of association defines its rules and regulations. The next difference, memorandum of association is subordinate to the Companies Act, and whereas articles of association is subordinate to the memorandum. Memorandum cannot be amended or changed retrospectively, whereas articles of association may be changed. The next difference is memorandum of association and articles of association is that the memorandum includes 6 compulsory clauses and 1 additional clause. That is in case of one person company, which I've explained in the previous session. While in articles of association may be drafted as per the company's needs and requirements. Memorandum of association is mandatory or compulsory for all the companies. While a public share company can use, there are different forms, that is Table A in place of articles of association. The last difference which we are going to discuss in this session is an alteration may be made in a memorandum of association only after passing special resolution in annual general meeting and after obtaining prior approval from the central government. It is compulsory to obtain the permission from central government. Whereas, while any changes in articles of association may be made by passing a special resolution at annual general meeting. Students, hope you understood the differences between memorandum and articles of association. So let's summarize whatever we have discussed till now. The articles of association can be considered the constitution of a company. It outlines the rules and regulations that stipulates a company's internal
Management Affairs. The Articles of Association are also considered as a user's manual for an organization that states the purpose of the organization and its strategies to accomplish its both short-term and long-term goals. Generally, the Articles of Association includes a company's legal name, address, purpose, equity capital, organization of the company, financial provisions, and provisions regarding the shareholders' meeting. Hope you have understood the contents which I've elaborated in this session about Articles of Association. Let's move on to know what are the most likely questions in your examination. With this understanding, you'll be able to answer the question, define Articles of Association. When you're defining, don't forget to mention it is according to the Companies Act 2013, Section 2, Subsection 5. Next, write all the contents of Articles of Association. For the question, explain the contents of Articles of Association. You can expect another question, which is differentiate between Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. Dear students, hope this session has helped you in understanding and help you to write in your examination. I am my best wishes for your learning process. Thank you all, dear students.